How's everyone tonight? Election night. I was driving along today, and I was thinking ahead, and I asked the Prime Creator for some grace to show me where should I go, you know, in these times. What's going to happen? And suddenly, I saw through the windshield this, like, a burst of beautiful leaves coming down and right in front of me, and I drove into them, and they hit the windshield, and they went whoosh. It was incredibly beautiful. All these leaves appeared like that. Now, there were trees that I was driving under where these leaves were on the trees, but there's no wind. I didn't hit the tree or anything. It just a burst, like a cloud of leaves. These beautiful leaves came and washed over me like that. And I said, wow, leaving. Going to leave. I'm going to leave. And so I said, okay, that's fine. So it's the worst of times and the best of times now. The best of times is that it means now it's time to leave. It's time for the Exodus to begin, officially begin, and we can look forward to how is the grace of the Prime Creator going to now play out in these times. So it's really the best of times. That's how I'm looking at things right now. Very best of times. Because we can look forward to some wonderful grace of some sort of exodus in some way. How that plays out, I'm not sure, but it's very evident to me, has been for a long time, that there will be a time of exodus as the world implodes here, and it's going to accelerate very quickly now, because there's no more checks, there's no more breaks. The world has no more breaks at all, you know. Unrestrained. Now, some other things happened today which were pretty amazing, very amazing. I found out that without these breaks, without restraint, people who ordinarily seem very debonair and cool and intellectual become extremely hysterical and angry and bellicose and vicious. And that is going to happen too. No restraint anymore. No restraint. So I look forward to the days to come, the next 55 days till January 1st, as a time of miracles, as a time of God, the Prime Creator's grace for those who see the writing on the wall. What happened was America, tonight America committed suicide is what happened. And along with it, the rest of the world. Which is, of course, what belief I've been telling you is going to happen. Belief constantly destroys itself. It set up an extremely destructive time here. And that is going to unfold. Leaks on it anymore. As expected. So now that we've got that out of the way, there's no more debate, no more argument, no more doubt whatsoever. It is most certainly here now. And there won't be any more breaks. That's very evident now at this point. Which is, you know, is a challenge and a good thing in certain ways, because we have deadlines. We have pressure. We have, you know, the supreme importance to connect with the grace of God in the most powerful way possible. With the grace of truth, with the grace of reality, with the grace of what is, with the grace of immutable oneness and all-inclusiveness of reality, the grace of the permanence, the invulnerability of reality, the grace from that which can never be threatened in any way, that which is real, that which is true, that grace now can come to us and say, hey, I told you so. Didn't I tell you? I've been telling you for years, you know, this will come pass, and these times will come to pass. And it's here now. And so the grace of that which is true identity, which is true life, which is true experiencing, has the opportunity now to come to us and say, hey, look, I told you this would happen. We've come to this. Now will you accept my help? And we'll say, okay, yeah. So it's actually the very best of day, best of times possible. And that's more than putting a silver lining on things, actually. It's true. It is true. Because no more excuses, you know. You have to be a suicidal maniac not to turn to God's grace at this time and say, hey, yeah, we really do need the fullness of God's grace right now. And unfortunately, in the world, there's a lot of people who are suicidal maniacs, who self-destructive, extremely self-destructive. And because of what the goal of belief is, they're going to be loyal to belief and its projection. It's a belief that it projects its own insanity upon truth, upon reality. And, you know, some will go with that, and some will go with the grace of God now. And the division will be, you know, it's very stark at this point now. There's no more excuses for anybody. So we have, you know, great times to look forward to, actually, because of the fullness of the grace of God can now appear to give us the big boost that we need to depart from the self-destructivity that this world has chosen as a path. Because we don't need that. We're returning to acceptance of what is. That's all. We never left reality. We just tried to deny it. We just tried to refuse to accept it as it is. But it doesn't mean we left it. It's like we fall asleep, we have a dream. That doesn't, you know, we're dreaming all this stuff. Doesn't mean we're not still there in the bed. We're still in reality. We've just been trying to deny reality, trying to change it. And when we decide to accept reality as it is, then the grace of God shows up in our lives and helps us gravitate towards that acceptance and that welcome home, you know, the welcome wagon shows up. So I've seen this long ago. Fifteen years ago, I saw all this happening, and I did see the grace of God coming in at this time and taking us in the direction of accepting reality as it is. And it's a tremendous, tremendous thing, situation we're in right now. That's my take on the situation, and that's how I see it. And, you know, I've seen it for a long, long time, but you just have to let things play out, you know. People keep thinking, you know, maybe we don't need the grace of God. You know, maybe we can, you know, fix all this situation in the world right now. But obviously, that is should be apparent now that that is just a fantasy. So I look forward to the days to come extremely. I made my weight 5 weeks, lost 15 pounds, 3 pounds a week. Made 185 on election day was my goal. And a tremendous amount of hard work today. My body, you know, was able to get through it. And very flexible, supple, flexible, agile, strong. Everything, you know, it's basically there. I'm really tired from the day, you know. It's a lot of heavy carrying, heavy stuff, but I'm feeling fine, feeling great. Making the weight was a huge thing, and looking forward now to being able to move with the grace of the Prime Creator, and to accelerate this process of the coming home, the welcome home process, meaning accepting reality as it is, the willingness to accept what is as it is, instead of trying to have a fantasy of changing it, have a belief that it's possible to change it. And there are those in the world, this world has decided to go in the direction of continuing to believe it's possible to, you know, to change belief, to change reality, really. And the belief that it's possible to change reality leads to destruction. It's the way of destruction. Because belief has to keep destroying itself to try to give evidence that it's that there is some power of destructivity. See, in reality, there's nothing that I've destroyed, nothing that I've harmed. Hey, there's no such thing as a power of destructivity. Only in belief. It's only when the Son of God wants to be Prime Creator and therefore trying to deny reality as it is, does this belief arise in destructivity. And really, intellectualism is the religion of belief, and it believes it can do everything. And if it starts to, if it's failing, it scapegoats and projects blame on truth and becomes vicious, you know. So I know intellectuals very well. If you look out throughout history, the unbelievable viciousness of intellectuals when they are unchecked in power and unchecked. Soviet Union, you know. Lenin and Trotsky set the whole thing up, and then you got the thugs of, you know, Stalinism. But the intellectuals set the whole thing up. Same with in China, Maoists were intellectuals, really. And Nazi Germany was actually German intellectuals that laid the groundwork for that. And the worst situations in the history of the world have come from intellectuals being unchecked. Okay, the balance, the whole getting completely out of balance and being unchecked, and then a flip side arises from them. It's interesting. I told you about yesterday that an acquaintance of mine told me about this. His friend, who he's always been friends, and this guy he thought he was very cool, very calm, very respectable. Where he drank too much tequila, and his reserve was lost. He lost his reserve, and he completely changed his personality, like Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde, and became just insane, absolutely insane, vicious, frightening. And my acquaintance said he became demonic, and scared the heck out of him. And because he said he's never seen his friend has always been a cool, calm, collected guy. You see? So right now we have a situation where the people are drinking the Kool-Aid, and they're going to drink it to such an extent that the whole personality, the flip side, the Mr. Hyde is going to emerge. Is exactly what's going to happen. You have Dr. Jekyll, very cool, calm, collected intellectual, and then you have Mr. Hyde. And when circumstances go a certain way, Mr. Hyde turns up. And you don't want to be around when Mr. Hyde turns up. That is for sure. And the grace of God knows all about this. It pre-warned me, you know, 15 years ago about all this. And has been showing me progressively, very clearly, you know, get ready, prepare to accept the grace of God. The ambassadors of reality, the big boost, you know, and the tremendous help that we have coming to help us out, to help us gravitate back to accepting what is. And to get out of the way of Mr. Hyde. I had an experience today with an acquaintance who's always very cool and calm, collected, and debonair and suave and everything, and he suddenly flipped into Mr. Hyde. It's unbelievable. It became extremely bellicose. And it's like, I'm just watching with amusement, you know, saying, okay, this is what's going to happen. It doesn't take much to flip, you know, just a certain constellation of events and situations where they become unchecked, or somehow Dr. Jekyll turns into Mr. Hyde, boom. And I didn't say anything, I just nodded and said, okay, and then just left. Didn't bother me at all. Didn't get shocked, didn't get upset, didn't argue. I just watched the performance. I said, there's Mr. Hyde. Here comes Mr. Hyde. Right on cue. Right on cue. So you will see that. You will see that. And when a certain type of personality set construct gets emboldened and has nothing to check it, phew, look out. Here comes Mr. Hyde. And of course, Mr. Hyde is seeking those... seeking Dr. Jekyll to destroy Dr. Jekyll. Those who are truly calm and peaceful and clear and see the big picture and are aligned with what is, they're the targets, because it's projection, scapegoating and projection. Belief projects onto truth, you know, which is why Jesus was murdered, crucified. It belief projected onto Jesus. Everything that was wrong with belief projected it onto Jesus. And no, there it is. Let's kill. And now we're free of it. And that's exactly what's coming, is mass projection onto those who are actually aligned with truth and saying, there's the problem, there's all the insanity right there. We get rid of that, everything will be fine, we'll have a golden age, and see, we solved the problem. That's how intellectuals solve the problems, is through genocide, the pogroms, education, etc., the gulags, and the work camps in China, and the Nazi concentration camps, etc. That's how they solve the problems of the world, the belief. Get rid of those scapegoats. Get rid of those that they projected. The insanity of belief and the futility of belief in trying to change reality is projected onto those who recognize that reality cannot be changed. And belief says, oh, you're the ones who are insane. We're going to get rid of you and our problems will be all over. So we're right there. Okay, we officially jumped over the threshold tonight. Not a bit surprisingly. So you should remain amused, slightly amused. Don't be shocked, for sure. Just notice it. Just quietly notice, okay? Okay. That's what's up. That's what's up. Okay. Just like I did today. I just noticed this bellicose hystericalness, you know, and just sort of, okay, okay. Fine. See you later. Adios. Like that. Just quietly departed. You know, okay, make different plans. Everything worked out great. Everything worked out great for me, actually. I had to change plans, you know. I was denied what I was told to do, and then I just shifted gears, changed plans, and everything worked out great. And the rest of the day, you know, flowed beautifully. So let me tell you, don't get in any arguments with anybody or debates at all. Okay, that is my advice. Just be amused. Just smile. Okay. And shift gears, you know. Shift directions, that kind of thing. Don't engage in any sort of argumentation at all. Or lamentation or argumentation or in any way. Simply be flexible, right? I talk about flexibility. 5 weeks ago, I didn't have flexibility in my body at all. I couldn't even play golf. I quit. Because I literally, the wheels came off and I couldn't hit any shots because I had no flexibility. And now I've been working for 5 weeks on flexibility and lost 15 pounds. And now my flexibility is good. It's good. It's really good. And just in time, because now is when you need that flexibility. You know, you just say, okay, we'll just change direction, you know. The wind's blowing, okay, you know, go this way kind of thing. We just be flexible. Feel that flexibility. When you feel flexibility, like you can move where you need to move to, you don't get upset. I didn't get upset today. I didn't feel stuck. I just hopped in the truck and, you know, and I felt nimble, you know, I feel nimble. I feel quick. I feel flexible. And I told you, you have to have this before this election. That's why I've been hammering on that for several months, or really a couple of years, but the last several months, September and October, I said, you've got to get, you know, by this election, you must have gained momentum. Okay, you have to have gained momentum, because now you use that flexibility, that nimbleness, you know, to be unaffected. You say, okay, I'm ready to go with the grace of God. I'm ready to move with the grace of God, to flow with it. And I can dodge, you know. I'm ready to dodge, get out of dodge, as a matter of fact. Time to get out of dodge. Absolutely time to get out of dodge. And you can do it. You know, you can jump on that horse and ride out of dodge. Absolutely, I feel I could do that. 5 weeks ago, no way. So this is an example of being alerted to what's coming and then doing the right thing ahead of time in preparation, you know, trusting and having faith that, yeah, this intuitive alert is accurate, and then taking drastic steps to respond to it. You know, I basically starved myself for 5 weeks to lose the weight. And, you know, sure, I was really hungry and tired at times, but the payoff, you know, is huge. Just, you know, have what I need, you know. And so I don't feel stuck. Feel like I can move with the grace of God now, which is a great feeling. A I can't believe I've only been talking 90 minutes. It feels like an hour. Is this true? 19 minutes? How is that possible? I don't know. Wow. Time. So when you see something happen that you saw ahead of time, it's likely to happen, and you see how, you know, Dr. Jekyll can turn into Mr. Hyde, and I said, this is probably going to happen, then it happens right in your life, boom, you see it happen like that, and you just notice and say, ah, there it is right there, Exhibit A, you know, Exhibit A. It's happened throughout history many times. And, of course, history repeats itself. And for those who are aware that history repeats itself, they're able to get out of Dodge. I mean, Lao Tzu, back in China, when a certain situation happened, Lao Tzu said, that's it. Adios, amigos. And they stopped him at the border into the Himalayas, and probably to Tibet. And they said, hey, you know, we don't want you to leave. And he said, well, I'm leaving. And they said, well, you know, do you have anything? Can you help us? And he said, okay, here you go. I'll give you some wisdom. And then, you know, he left, headed for the hills as it was. And there are times in history where you have to head for the hills. You have to get out of Dodge, and you have to go with the grace of God entirely. And you have to leave self-destructiveness behind. You have to leave it behind. You know, the whole belief system, self-destruction, believing that somehow this is the answer, you know, because it's going to develop the power to threaten reality and force the prime creator to change reality and make the Son of God prime creator. There's that clinging to that false, crazy hope, you know, false hope. And times get extremely self-destructive. And you can recognize and say, here we go again. You know, here we go again. Of course, what do you expect within belief? Belief is ceaseless devouring itself. It's the worm Ouroboros, you know, devouring its tail. Never ends, but sometimes it gets very voracious. And right now it's become very, very voracious. And I've said that everybody's been dumbed down, put into a sacrificial mode on this planet. The planet is in extreme sacrificial mode. If you know what to look for, you know what a sacrificial mode is, and then you look at the planet and the people and you realize they are absolutely in like a sacrificial zombie-like mode where they're just lemmings, you know, marching to their destruction. It's completely obvious. And I have to say, you know, thanks, but no thanks. Not interested in that anymore. And people are celebrating their self-destruction, the destruction of, you know, symbolic self, as if it's a great victory. Because they believe it will result in a great victory eventually, once they are destroyed, but that will somehow activate, catalyze some, you know, some super weapon that we use against reality, using this destructivity, this, you know, it's a fantasy. It's just a fantasy. That's all it is. It's just pure imagination. No truth to it whatsoever. Sacrifice never brings you anything that you really want. Never. Never threatens reality in the slightest bit. So it's all in vain. And yet, once you get put into a sacrificial mode, which lasts 50 years or 55 years on this planet, ever since I've been here, has been just this tremendous nonstop ritual pressure to get people into the sacrificial mode. Every aspect of culture has been employed to induce this, you know, this stupor, where you literally embrace self-destruction, thinking that it's salvation. You know, sacrifice always, those who embrace sacrifice always do so because they believe it is salvation. That is a fact. Otherwise, they wouldn't embrace it at all. When you see it isn't salvation, then of course, no reason to embrace it. Beautiful, beautiful evening here in the Bay Area, California. Crickets are still chirping. It was 86 degrees again today, second day in a row. We've had just this brilliant, blue, clear, beautiful weather and days. That just everything is crystal clear and highlighted, you know, against this backdrop has just been amazing days, but that's going to change. You know, it is going to change. Wednesday, tomorrow, the cool air mass is supposed to start coming in, and then Thursday, it's supposed to be very cold, drop 20 degrees or more, rain, and then rain. So this gorgeous, you know, weather is about to come to an end. And probably, you know, winter will be upon us. So my attitude right now is one of tremendous anticipation based on the visions I've had in the past that show what's going to happen. And I have seen that the grace of God shows up in a big, big way and literally enables us to switch, to leave self-destruction behind. Absolutely, that is what's going to happen. That's what I've seen. And I do expect that to happen. I prepared for it. And it's likely to be the very best of times for those who want to leave. Stop embracing sacrifice. Very simple. Want to go beyond belief. Set belief down. Set sacrifice down. Set insanity down. Set self-destruction down. Set all of that down, and leave it behind. You know, the time for us will be the very best of times. It's incredible. Incredible opportunity now. Incredible opportunity, really. There's no more, you know, there's no more sitting on the fence. I mean, it's a fait accompli. The whole situation is now here right in front of us, and there's no going back now. So no more excuses. Absolutely no more excuses, which is a great thing. So I'm tremendously optimistic and upbeat and looking forward to the immediate days ahead as days that will be actually full of miracles. I expect them. I absolutely expect them. That hasn't happened yet, but there's been many, many indications that it's on the brink of happening. I just keep saying, why are you waiting? Why are you waiting? Because it has to have a cut and dried situation where you say, okay, you know, where you realize, wow, okay. The world's decided to commit suicide. You know, I don't want to do that. I want to go with the grace of God and re-embrace life, which is what is reality. Not a fantasy of belief, but reality as it is. And decided, that's what I've decided to do. And now it's go time. It is go time. So this is really tremendous. We have now officially entered into go time. Okay? 55 days of go time. Let's look at it that way. And let us see how this go time unfolds for us. Fantastic. All right. I'll keep this one short because I'm sure you're probably pretty busy at this time. So very great, wonderful video. And that's it for this video.